Hey, it's Dr. Nadia here, and I wanted to pop in today to talk about an issue that has been a topic for not only my colleagues and I, but also just coming up a lot recently with some of my clients. And as you're preparing for 2018 and putting together your strategy and all of those different pieces, I think it's important to also take into account, just really mapping out some of the timelines and setting that up as you're looking at your cash flow and your projections and all of those, how all of those pieces work together. And this challenge is actually lead generation. So there are a couple different pieces to this puzzle, if you will. There's the lead generation piece of really being able to attract the number of people that you need that are going to come into your business according to whatever your goals are. Then there is the part of once they're in to your community or into, if you have a certain funnel that you have set up, then what is that whole nurture sequence like? What does that look like as you're building that know, like, and trust factor, as you are really letting them know what makes you different in the marketplace and really starting to build that relationship before you make your offer. Now, I know that each of those offers, everybody's offer is different, everyone's strategy. So you have those that are definitely more focused on a lower end. So they're looking for high volume, low dollar amounts in terms of what that offer is. Or you may be looking for, you may still be high volume, but it's a high dollar amount. So your whole lead gen and nurture sequence may differ in how you approach it. And of course, it's also, you know, based on your personality and all that good stuff. But one of the things that has been coming up is there's that whole lead gen. So you're bringing in new people that are new to your world. They're new to your community. They're getting to know you. You're building that relationship. And what is the time from the time that someone opts into your free gift or checks in on one of your webinars or joins your Facebook group? What is the time from the time that they take that action to the time they actually buy? And what does that timeline look like? And so one of the conversations that's been coming up is there feels like there's this, it's a longer timeline, which will then impact your projections and how you approach in terms of your cash flow. So it's a very real number that you'll definitely want to pay attention to as you're preparing for 2018. It just makes sense. So if you, one, if you're feeling the pinch or you're feeling like, what is going on? Trust that you're in good company. And then also as you're planning your strategy, are there some things that you may need to supplement your strategy with? Are there some, maybe you need to also not only look at new people that are coming in, but what about re-engaging people that are already connected to you? Like, what does that strategy look like? What, and again, it's a timeline. So it doesn't necessarily mean you can just send out a single email or do a campaign or any of that stuff to, you know, get a number of people in. But I want you to really look at in terms of if you're saying, I need 40 clients or I need 10 clients or whatever those numbers are for your business. And I know a lot of times we have multiple things. So it's not just a single, you're like, Nadia, I need 10 over here, but I need 40 over here and I need 3 over here. Like, I get it. But just paying attention to what that looks like. So as you're looking at your strategy, I also want you to kind of look review. So do a year in review this year, what those timelines have looked like, what strategies have worked well, things that you might want to tweak for next year, and prepare for that. And also, again, and I mentioned this in an earlier video, where you're looking at the budgeting for that. And so one of those line items that I outlined was, you know, what is your marketing budget? Whether that's Facebook ads, sponsorships, LinkedIn ads, Google AdWords, I don't know what your strategy is, but what is the budget for that? And does your budget really align with your vision? So when you think about what are the number of people you need to get in front of, and as you're working through, if you have a funnel, that's the whole thing. Like, you have a large number and you kind of whittle it on down, right? So what is that number that you have to start to generate to start the relationship process to get to the number of people that you want? in your business. This is also key because a lot of times as we're growing and developing our businesses, our strategies change. And so one word of caution I want to put out there is to be careful of wanting to switch to a more leveraged model without having a good transition plan. So I'm not saying don't switch or transition to a more leveraged model, because I get it. We only have X amount of hours in a day, and you may not want to have to worry about building a big team and managing team. Totally get it. But I want you to then think about what that transition will look like. So as you maybe stop working more with one-on-one clients, or even doing like group coaching or things like that, you may say, you know what, I want to transition my business and where I may have a lower dollar, a membership, a community where I can really get in and I can touch more people. Again, looking at your revenue goals, what your strategy is, but also what's the cost or the expense or even the investment, depending on how you look at it, that it takes to actually do that. What's the cost per lead so that you can really start to understand like what strategies are working best for you and what makes the most sense as you move into 2018 as you're planning this out. So I'm finding a lot of people are like, oh my goodness, Dr. Nadia, I have a sales issue. You know, I'm not generating the revenue I desire in my business. And what I'm finding as we have this conversation, I really started to take a peek under the hood, if you will. It's not so much a sales issue as it is a lead generation issue. Like there just aren't enough people so there may be that number, or it's not enough of the right people. Because again, only a very small part of your pool of people or prospects, if you will, are ready to buy like right now. It's very small, less than 5%. So again, some people are just coming in and it's going to be a while before they buy, but now they're part of your community. You're going to be doing different things and engage with them and nurture that relationship and connect and do all those things. And yes, there are things that you can do to expedite that. But again, I want you to look at your overall strategy and start to kind of look at where those people may come in and where they may fall, really taking a look at those percentages and those numbers so that you can then delegate not only dollars, but time and strategy around, okay, what is it really going to take in order to grow my business, to get the people in my classes or my webinars or my programs or at my events? Like my clients do all this stuff. And so we're having these conversations as we're preparing to go into 2018 and we're looking and we're evaluating and we're starting to see, okay, what's converting and what's not? What are the activities that we're doing to not only build those relationships, but also get people to take action? And one of the things I can tell you is that if you don't have enough people, or you haven't done that enough of that work on the front end from the lead gen and the marketing side to then when it comes down to actually get to the sales piece of that. And depending on how your business is, that's those two are very intertwined and it's a little bit harder to kind of decipher where that line is. Then I can tell you, if you haven't done that well on the front end, then you're going to see that reflect in your bottom line. Doesn't mean it's not a great product, doesn't mean it's not a great offer, doesn't even mean you're not good at sales. It just may mean, and I see this more times than I care to admit, is that you're one, not talking to enough people or engaging with enough people or attracting enough people or generating enough leads, like however you want to look at that, and or you're just not attracting or engaging enough of the right people. And then being sure to then look at those places where you're inviting them to take action, where you are continuing to truly nurture that relationship, providing value, connecting, and maybe not selling in that moment. And I know you may be like, wait, Dr. Nadia, what are you talking about? This is sales. I get it. And I also understand that trust and relationship are very important. And if you haven't done that and given enough time for that, then that may be why people aren't buying. It's not that they're not interested. It's not that they don't want it. Definitely not that they don't need it. But there's just not been enough nurturing there, enough connection, enough of the right call to action. So I want you to just take some time and think about that. Definitely do your year in review as you're preparing for next year. But then also, you know, what are some of the things that are working really well in your business right now? So you may have a Facebook ad that's doing really well. Speaking may be doing really well. Sponsorships, doing a really taking a look at the numbers, understanding that ROI. What's the cost to per client that you get, per customer that you're getting in your business? And then also, again, as I mentioned before, what is your engagement strategy? Because once you start to really look at these hard numbers, it's a lot cheaper and or a lot less expensive, I'll put it that way, to work with clients who are already familiar with you, who are already familiar with your work, who already adore you, and to get them to come back. And of course, there's going to be a level of attrition, like people move on, but there may also be some areas in there where you're leaving some money on the table. So I invite you to take a look at all of those to really understand what the expenses are behind your strategy and even your revenue goals. So if you have a revenue goal of $120,000, what does it really cost to get to that? And then being sure to look at that, because your revenue goal may be different from your, this is what I pay myself, my paycheck goal, right? So again, looking at all those numbers as I went through in an earlier video, and I kind of went through like, okay, here's revenue, here's what I pay me, here's what I give, but then, you know, here are all the other things that it takes to make my business run. And again, that looks different for everyone. So I just wanted to pop in today and talk about that a little bit. Is it really lead gen? Is it sales? Is it a combination of the two? Like, really taking some time to analyze that, because you may go into the new year, if you don't do that well or don't take time to do that, thinking you're trying to fix one problem and it's a different problem. And you want to really just leverage that momentum, start the year off strong. So that's why I'm walking you through different ways and giving you different ideas and things to think about as you're preparing to do that. Because those are some of the things that I'm doing right now with my clients. We're looking at, okay, what is working? What do I really want to accomplish next year? Is that the best strategy? And, you know, I'm like, you know, I have to be honest. Like, I don't think that's the best strategy. Here's what may work better. Here's why I think this works better from a marketing perspective, so that then you have enough people to talk to who are ready. Because remember, that percentage of people who are ready right this second is small. And then the percentage of people who may think they might be ready, that you will be then, once they engage with you and they're like, okay, yeah, I'm ready to do it now, that's a little bit bigger, right? But then there's a process for that too. And then those others are like, I know I need to do this. I probably will do this at some time. I may even do this with you, but not right now. Perfect. Great. But again, when you look at your cash flow goals, you're like, yeah, that's good. And I'm excited that you one day want to work with me. And I get that you may need to work on some things to make that a reality. But in the meantime, I have goals. So I definitely want you to just take some time to look at that, do that year in review, look at those different areas. But again, you know, it may not be a sales issue, especially for those of you who are like, you know what, it's time for me to bring on a sales team. It's even more critical when you bring on a sales team that you have that lead gen piece in place so that your team is active in doing things. But then also don't forget, because sometimes we get so caught up in lead gen and going out and getting new people, which is great, that you already have people in your community that need a touch from you, if you will. And what are some of the strategies that you have in terms of not only lead gen, but also continued engagement from your existing community, from your existing clients, from your former clients? Because there is gold there in terms of just building those relationships, continuing to stay connected. So as you continue to grow and evolve and they continue to grow and evolve, should you create new offers, because that's what we do as entrepreneurs, we create new stuff, then there are people there that they already trust you. You don't have to generate that trust because it already exists. So again, you know, is it lead gen or is it sales? Is it a combination of the two? What is your marketing strategy? What is your marketing budget? Like, you know, there are some things we have to sometimes pay for. Things are constantly changing. If you don't believe it, just look at Facebook. Whether that's your platform of choice or not, just trust and believe. Facebook is always changing something that then could or may or may not impact your business in terms of what you're marketing. But then also taking a look at, you know, where did my marketing dollars go in 2017? And what was the ROI on those marketing dollars? And would it be better for me to start shifting some things in 2018? Or do I just double down? I'm like, well, this was great. Things are working well. Let's, you know, continue to do those things that have worked for your community and your business model. So again, understanding one, what your model is. Is it high volume, low dollar? High volume, high dollar? Or is it low volume, high dollar? Or low volume, low dollar? Not really sure what your revenue goal would look like with that one, but that may or may not be your goal. At this point, you may be new. You're like, okay, I just want to get a handful of clients to get me through and test some things out. But again, looking at your revenue goal, taking time to really look at what you need. And then if you need X amount of clients, working at backwards, how many people do you have to get in front of to have the conversations or drive to your landing page to then take the action in order to get the results you need? And then what's the timeline and the nurturing process in terms of from the time that they become aware that this is an option to the time that they say, yes, I'm ready to buy and input their credit card number, because that is also a process that will definitely impact your bottom line. All right, so this is Dr. Nadia. I'm super excited about going into 2018. I'm telling you, my clients and I are rocking it out. I'm looking at our numbers and looking under the hood. And, you know, we're having some challenging conversations. You know, it's like, it's been uncomfortable. Even as I look at my own business, like, what do I want to do next year? And is what I'm doing now what I want to do forever? You know, so those things that I tell you the things that I see not only for my clients, but also for myself. Like, this is a real process, and really just understanding what it really takes and just keeping it real. Like, you know, I'm not going to tell you that it's free and you can just go out there and just post something and everybody's going to flock, and it's half the people won't even see it. Like, this was real. Unless you do the things to make sure it gets seen. But then again, that costs money. So I want you to look at your strategy. If you have any questions or you want to schedule some time with me to just, you know, for us to do that and do that analysis and really take a look at where you can improve, where there may be some gaps in your overall strategy as you prepare to move into 2018. I would love to do that. You head on over to meetwithdrnadia.com. That's meetwithdrnadia.com, and schedule some time on my calendar. I don't have a ton of time between now and the end of the year, so those spots are definitely limited, but would love to have that conversation with you and help prepare you and position you for success. All right, so this is Dr. Nadia signing off. Have an amazing day and get to planning.